Hello everyone, welcome again, and I am very happy to be with you today. I hope everyone is having a good day. So again, I would like to thank you all for being with me and for following this channel. Thank you very much for being a blessing to me and my family, and may you always find encouragement in this channel. Please don't forget to hit subscribe and like this video so that we can always be together to encourage each other during our journey. So before we start, let us pray. Dear God, please cleanse our hearts of self-pity and resentments. We want to trust that your good plan for our lives are being carried out in our present circumstances. We know that you love us and you always have our best interests at heart. Please help us to be patient, and in the meantime, please help us to endure and keep our hearts and minds focused on only you and your promises. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so today I will talk to you about what the Holy Spirit has made me understand in this journey that I am taking. I was told by the Holy Spirit that delay is not denial. I am sure that at one point in our lives or during this stand, we have asked ourselves why we are doing this. And we always go back to the time when we have been given by God the promise of restoration. Has God given you a promise that has yet to be fulfilled? Perhaps this promise was given to you through a post in social media, you know, that you chanced upon and it spoke to you while you were reading it, or while you were reading the Bible, a verse just really tugged at your heart or just really kept tugging at your heart. It could have been, you know, a verse that leaped out of the Bible that really caught your attention. You blinked, having never really noticed it before. No, the words just jump off the page and pierce your heart and really spoke to you. Or maybe this promise came in a form of a specific answer to a request while you were praying. Or it could have also been that you heard the voice of the Holy Spirit speak to you directly, in a dream, in a vision, in so many forms. But then, nothing really happened. You see no movement, no change, nothing that you can see in the natural. In fact, it could even be that your circumstances turned for the worst. Doubt started to creep in your head. Then you start to wonder if you just misinterpreted God's intentions, if it was just all in your head. Or maybe sometimes we even think that maybe we had just imagined it or made it up. This happens to most, if not all of us. Have you come to this point when you physically sought out the promised blessings and you tried your best to find it yourselves? Did you start to ask our questions? Where, Lord, where are the promised blessings? In Genesis chapter 37 through 48, you will see that as a young man, God gave Joseph, the son of Jacob, a promise that one day he would rule. But then, for the next 13 years, everything went exactly opposite to the promise. His brothers even sold him. You know, they sold him to the Egyptians because they were very envious of him. So Joseph, who had God's promise that he would one day rule a nation, was now a slave. And it did not even stop there. As a slave in Potiphar's house, he was even falsely accused of raping his master's wife. Then he was thrown into the prison and forgotten. But guys, Joseph refused to let his circumstances shape his outlook. He allowed no self-pity or bitterness to rob him of his energy and of his belief and faith in God. Instead, he chose to use each circumstance, whether at home, at Potiphar's house, or while he was in prison, as God's appointed place where he should serve him with all of his heart. He never lost faith and held on and stood on God's promise. He never allowed anything to deter him, nor did he allow anything to remove his focus from God. He was steadfast in his faith. So, God eventually blessed Joseph and made him a blessing to others. So guys, you know, instead of using the delayed promise as a reason to grumble against God, Joseph kept it in the back of his mind to give him courage and strength. He let go of expectations of how and when God would carry out the promise. In the meantime, he never knew, but he believed that God was up to something much bigger than he could have ever imagined. In God's time, in God's perfect time, Joseph's life completely changed. His wisdom and his loyalty was recognized by God. What happened then? He eventually became Pharaoh's right-hand man, the second in command all over Egypt. Remember, guys, he was a slave. Now, he was second in command to rule all over Egypt. In this role, Joseph ended up saving so many lives. You know, he even saved the lives of his own family, his own brothers who sold him to the Egyptians for him to be made a slave. Not only did he save his family, his brothers, his father, he was in the end reunited with them. And aside from that, he also was the man who saved most of Egypt from starvation. So we have to know, guys, that God always has a good plan for our lives too. They may not be as grand as that of Joseph, but God has a purpose for each of us. In Jeremiah 29, verse 11, which is my very favorite verse in the Bible, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." These are not just words written down for people thousands of years ago. They resonate with us today. God's promise is real in any age and in any time. We might just have to wait for that promise to come to fruition though. But it is real, guys. Trust Him. Trust Him even when life doesn't make sense. There is a purpose in what you are going through. In what I am going through, I know that. And it's hard, but I have my trust only in God. Perhaps God is trying to correct your course. I know He's trying to correct my course. It could also be that He's using these trials to teach you to lean more on Him. I definitely can tell you that it was one of the things that He wanted me to do. Lean more on Him and lean on Him alone. And guys, I am telling you, I have done that and continue to do that. Lean on Him, trust His timing, and as we do this, He is strengthening our faith too. We may also be in this waiting period because we're going through this because God wants us to be able to influence others in their decisions to follow Christ, to be able to be there and empathize to others who may be in the exact same situation we are, or in situations wherein they need to see the light, and you can be that light for them, to influence them to follow God. It is possible also that wading through all of this mess in our lives, you know, will help us lead someone else through a similar circumstance later on. Or there are still things in us that needs to be revealed and removed. Remember, we only see what our physical eyes show us, but God sees everything. We do not see what is on the other side of the mountain, but God does. Like Joseph, we may not see the purpose for our struggles until much later, but also like him, we should remain faithful and trust that God knows what is happening. God may seem silent But that doesn't mean that He has walked away from us. It doesn't mean that He's done nothing. We should always be reminded of God's words, that what comes out of His mouth does not come back void. God allows you to be at a standstill because He is teaching you something. He is actually at work in the background. We do not know that, but what we know is that God is working for us. This is not our battle. This is the Lord's. It's just like a building going up behind a wall. We can't see the progress. We don't know. We don't always know how much has been done. But that doesn't mean nothing is happening. God's ways, not our ways. God's thoughts are not our thoughts. You have to know and you have to believe that God's plan is being carried out, and this set of circumstances are needed to prepare us for those plans. As Joseph's life points out, even tragedy and evil can be part of God's plan for good. In Romans chapter 8, verse 29, it says, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose." So guys, a delay is not denial, but a time of preparing you for the promise. It is very hard, I know. I can understand. It is very hard when we cannot see God in action. But that doesn't mean He isn't acting on our behalf. I am so sure that there may be times while he was in prison that Joseph quietly called out to God for strength. Because you know, I do that a lot. So it's okay to do the same. But like Joseph, never give up on God. Whether you see evidence of it or you don't see anything right now, know that God will never give up on you. Whenever you feel discouraged or when you start to wonder if God is still there and if He cares, get down on your knees and pray. Call out to God. Worship, praise Him, and be very, very attentive to the Holy Spirit. You need not search the world for answers or manifestations. Go to the Word, because all the answers you need, you will find there. You will find it in the Word of God. So guys, always know in your heart and walk in faith that we may be delayed or you may be delayed, but you definitely are not denied. So guys, I hope that you know that God is working on your behalf, because I truly, truly believe that in my heart. I may not see it, but one day I will see the mountain has sunk in the sea. And I pray that the same will happen soon for each and every one of you in God's perfect time. Okay, so thank you very much, and I hope that this has encouraged you today. God bless you all and take care. Bye-bye. If you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please do, so that we can always be an encouragement to each other during this time where we stand on God's promises. So bye-bye again, and I hope to be back on soon.